Alright guys, so you want to know how to build your own awesome team in Monster Sanctuary. I'm going to run you through that with some tools and some general soft rules along the way, along with showing you some example team. Now a lot of people have asked for this in the comments down below, so I'm more than happy to oblige. And also thank you to all you guys who have subbed recently, you're awesome. Thank you. Right, so let's get some of the basics out of the way. First off, for your general team, you're looking for monsters which fill separate roles. So first up, you want a monster that is going to heal or shield your party at the start. You're then looking for a second monster that's going to either heal, add buffs, debuffs, and build up the combo. And then finally, you want your big old damage dealer at the back. And exactly how you want to deal the damage and what strategy you'll use to deal the damage is entirely up to you. And perhaps it's all about the type of enemy that you're facing. So perhaps you're after a champion monster, in which case you can go and look at their weaknesses and try and build a team around that. Alternatively, perhaps if you're facing the alchemists or you want to do some PvP, really in those situations, you want to build up a team that does high single target damage to take out one of the monsters in one round. And I mentioned stuff about that in my previous videos, taking on the alchemists. So, picking the monsters for the team, how do we go about it? Well, actually, I'm going to take you out of the game itself and over to a website. If you Google Monster Sanctuary Wiki, you get brought to the Monster Sanctuary Wiki. And this is a great tool. It lists all the monsters, it lists all the weapons, it lists items. Anything that you could possibly want to know about Monster Sanctuary is here in this wiki. So how am I going to start picking my team? Well, first let's say we want to look at some status effects. Perhaps we want a team that applies a whole host of debuffs to an enemy. Maybe we'll click on debuffs. Here it lists out all the skills that involve burn, chill, shock, poison, armor break and weakness. And we can scroll through and see every single skill that all of the monsters have. And what I like to do is I like to have a look and see what there is around and what might be interesting to build a team around a set skill. So for instance here, we've got Acid Spit. So Acid Spit, it's an aura. It's not a unique aura, which means we could actually stack multiple auras of the same type if we want. And this would allow allied reptiles to have a 7.5% chance to inflict poison or burn and can stack them additional times. So that means we wouldn't need a multi-burn. We'd already be able to stack two burns or two poisons. And if we have a team full of reptiles, we could get that damage up to 22.5% chance of inflicting a debuff. So let's have a look at that. So we can do that just by clicking on the skill, and it'll show us the monsters that have that skill. Okay. So we've got two, Vazuki and Imori. Interesting, interesting. But this skill also would work for all reptiles. So on top of that, we could click reptiles, and this will show you the host of reptiles that there are. So these are all the reptiles in the game. So we have a host of reptiles and a host of dragons as well. And now generally, every type has its own special skills. So for instance, these reptiles have this Acid Spit, or a couple of them do. But there are also additional skills available to reptiles, such as Carapace, which improves the healing and shielding skills of allied reptiles. Or we could look at aerial and reptile monsters dealing 7.5% increased damage. So if we look at prehistoric Screech, we can see there's just Kongamoto with that. Alternatively, we look at Carapace, we can see that Kame has that. So I quite like the idea of having three reptiles dealing multiple poisons and burns with their hits. So what it's really about now is finding out if they have complementing skill sets and also ensuring that we're filling each of those classes we require in a team. So actually, Kame actually fits quite nicely into the first slot of being like a shielder tank. So we can click on Kame. I'm just scrolling down past the bio and the skills. We have a list of all of the skills that he's got. Now, I like to look at the auras first. and looking at where they lie within the skill trees. So for instance, Carapace here, which is what attracted to us in the first place, is going to improve any healing and shielding skills. This sits within this shield tree, and we can see that he's got, I believe this is Protect. If we go to Support, we can see the Protect skill, which allows us to shield for defense, based on defense values. So immediately we're thinking, we're going to give Kaim a whole host of defense, allow him to shield, and these shielding skills are going to be increased for all the reptiles. So hopefully, with a large amount of shield, we can let the rest do a host of damage. So looking like we're going to take this side of the tree, we can also see there is Protected Offense, which is a passive. Let's have a look at the aura passive. So two amounts of Protected Offense, which means allied monsters deal 10% increased damage while shielded. So by shielding them, we're going to do 20% extra damage. This sounds like a good start. And what we also know about, or what we also notice about Kaim, is that he's got this skill that we've used in a previous video, Shield Burst, which if we look under damage, allows him to burst his shield by losing 50% of his shield and dealing 240% of the shield as damage, and it's undodgeable. We like this. So if we're going to build health and shield on Kaim, build up his shield, and then occasionally whack them with a shield burst, good for single target damage. We like this. So we're probably going to look to take the shielding tree. We look to get the shield burst, and then we might explore the other two trees where necessary. Okay, so we're happy that with Carapace, we're going to shield all the reptiles by an extra 20% of the shield that we're already creating with Kaim. And as we started this with Acid Spit, it might be worth looking at Vazuki and Imori. So, Vazuki. Again, we look at the auras. Always like to look at the auras first. Now, Vazuki comes with Fatal Upkeep, which means that the poison and the burn that we do through the reptile passive from Acid Spit is also going to do an additional 20% damage. Plus, remember, we're going to be able to stack it twice, one for each Acid Spit, if we get two monsters with the Acid Spit on them. And the damage is increased by 20%. Okay, I'm liking the look of this. There's also Severe Upkeep, where poison or burn does damage, 50% for chance to inflict a wound. So this also nicely fits in with the theme of doing poison and burn damage and upping the amount of poison and burn damage we can do. Also, Burning Desire, whenever burn does damage, apply shield. That fits in quite nice with Kaim, applying more shield, helping to power up the shield burst. And also under support, Vazuki fits quite a nice support role in that they've got Mass Restore, allowing to do the healing. Alternatively, there's also Fire Shield, which allows us to apply burn and additional shielding. So already I'm quite liking this synergy that we've got. Also, if we're not healing, and we're going to use Vazuki to build up our combos, Double Strike times 3 would give us 30% extra chance to trigger an additional hit. More hits, more combo. And again with Proliferate, applying a debuff, which hopefully we will do with the reptile auras that we have, that might trigger additional damage hits, again, building up the combo. So we're going to try and get two Acid Spits in here, and we're going to look at Imori as well. I should also point out that at the top of the bios, if you haven't collected the monster yet, it'll give you an idea of what region the monster's at. So for here, Sun Palace for Imori. Okay, so we've got our shielding tank. We've got our healing combo builder in the middle. Between them, they're going to be applying stacks because they're all reptiles, so they'll be applying debuffs. So really, Imori is coming in as our damage dealer. And again, even though it's a damage dealer, I like to look at the auras first. So we know we want to take Acid Spit. That was the aim of the team. So this looks like we're taking, at the very least, this second column. Under his special passives, he has a cooling, which every hit has a 10% chance to apply chill. Now, Imori's attacks can be a high frequency, doing like 8 or 5 attacks at a time. So that's 5 rolls at 10% chance each, which actually means that Congeal might not be a bad shout. Also, if you remember, Vazuki has Fatal Upkeep, which increases the damage from chill as well. So we may only be able to do one stack of chill, but it's still going to do extra damage. So we're interested. Okay, so we know we're going to be applying poison, we know we're going to be applying bleed, and we know we can apply chill just with many hits. So really, I might look at picking up something that can apply bleed just because we can build Imori with some critical hit chance. And actually, you can see he has skills that complement the bleed. So we can heal monsters when we apply bleed, and we can increase bleed damage on enemies by 40%. And really, you don't have to follow this team that I've made at all. I'm just trying to give you ideas about looking at items that complement one another and trying to understand how that gets together to form a solid team. Alternatively, you might like to just sort through all the monsters, in which case you can go to the monsters page and click on the monster table, and it'll give you a list of every monster in the game. You can click through, browse, and look at all their abilities and find ones that complement each other, or find additional auras that you can stack on top and have multiple instances of a same aura. So for instance, Sutsune here is quite heavily used in PvP. So, and looking through their passives, you can see that perhaps they have the bleed, they have feast, where whenever bleed does damage, it heals all monsters in the party. So perhaps you'd think, right, I want monsters that do bleed damage. So you can just click on the bleed here, see all the items that apply bleed, and think, ooh, okay, let's find what does the most damage. Fiery stabs does the most damage, fine. So we can click on fiery stabs. Who does fiery stabs? Imori, Sizzle Knight, Spinner, Sutsune, and Vodinoi. So perhaps I want multiple bleed applying monsters, and I'd go for a bleed build, in which case I think Sizzle Knight will do some tanking. And again, we'd go through the same process, look through the skills, see what complements Sutsune, and try and build a team out of that. So just a couple of rough ideas as well for an end game level, a level 40. What you'd look for is you'd hope that you have all of your monsters at around at least 4k health. On top of that, defense, you probably want at least 50% damage mitigation, which you can see in the skills section. An easy way to supplement your defense is through food. Peanuts are the way forward. And here again in the wiki, you can see peanuts are a treasure that appear in the underworld and can be dropped from Oculus and Mega Rocks most frequently. Similarly, for item builds, it's just a case of looking at what your most prominent skill is. So for instance, if you're shielding, it might be defense, or if you're healing, it might be the magic, and prioritizing that. However, what you also want to do is ensure that you have enough mana regen to at least cover what it would cost you to regen your main skill that you're going to use every time. So for instance here, if we were going to use Healing Wave, it would be, we need to make sure we have 210 mana regen to be able to keep using that every turn. And that's before any sort of debuffs and chills are applied to us. So with these skills, you can go forth and build PvP teams, build Infinity Arena teams, and that's exactly what I'm going to do next. So next up, we'll look at some Infinity Arena, and I'll work on trying to get as far as I can and try and share a team for you guys. If you've got any comments, please leave them below. I love hearing how you're all getting on. And a big thank you to all you guys who have subscribed. You're brilliant. Everybody, enjoy your Monster Sanctuary, and I will catch you in a bit.